Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel. I hope that you guys are having an amazing day today. In today's video, I am going to be showing you three different looks with the new Urban Decay Naked Ultraviolet palette. This is the same palette that we did the eye swatches on in the previous video. So if you guys are interested in seeing three different eyeshadow looks with this palette, then just keep on watching. To get started with the first eyeshadow look, I am going to prime my eyes using the P. Louise eyeshadow base in the shade 2.0. Starting off the first eyeshadow look with the shade Hacked, I am going to grab a blending brush and I'm just applying this right into the crease. As you guys can see, the mattes in this palette are extremely light. I did try to get it to go on a bit darker, so you will see me go into this eyeshadow a few times, but this is the darkest that I could get the color to look like. So if you guys want something a little bit darker, then definitely just grab another palette or any single eyeshadow that's a bit of a darker brown. But I am going to include a lot of the blending process in this video so that you guys can see a lot more of that. I know that a lot of you said that that was really helpful, so I hope that you don't mind, but if it's something that is too boring, let me know and I will take some of it out for the next video. Moving on to the transition color, I'm going to take this shade and apply it right up above the previous color, and using a blending brush, I'm just going to blend the two colors together, and I'm just going to keep adding until I see that it's very well blended and there are no harsh lines. So I thought I really wanted this look to be a little bit more rounded, but I didn't like the way that the blending looked at the edge, so I did end up cleaning it with a Q-tip. And now moving on to one of my favorite colors from the palette, you guys can see that I started applying it right on the lid because I wanted the look to be really easy and just something quick for you guys to do, but then I realized that I did not like the way that it was looking. So as you guys can see, I did take a Q-tip and I just cleaned it off the best that I possibly could, and I just went back into my P. Louise eyeshadow base to cut the crease. And now I can go back to the shade Lucid and apply it right over the crease that we just cut. So again, this is personal preference. You don't have to cut the crease. I just personally think that it looks better this way. But if you have a hard time cutting the crease or you just don't like the way that it looks, you can definitely do it the way that I tried to do it the first time, but I just think that this looks prettier in my own humble personal opinion. But anyway, moving on, so now I'm going back to the matte brown shade and I'm just applying that with a blending brush right at the edge of the cut crease to blend in the edges. Next, I am taking the darkest shimmer from the palette and I'm taking a small brush. You can either use a thin angled eyebrow brush like this one, or you can use the one that I'm using here. The angled one is from Hank and Henry Beauty and this second one is from Morphe. It is the second brush collection that they released with Jaclyn Hill, but basically you just want to create a nice winged liner with this shade. Next, I am taking this Urban Decay Game of Thrones Special Edition pencil and I'm just applying it to the inner corner. Moving on to the waterline, I'm taking this pencil by Urban Decay in the shade Double Life and applying it right into that waterline. And for the lower lash line, I'm coming back in with the dark brown shimmer and using the brush that came with the Urban Decay Ultraviolet palette. I'm just applying that and making sure that I blend it out. For mascara, I'm using this one from CoverGirl, which is actually an amazing drugstore mascara. I've been trying to use a whole bunch of different mascaras just so I can use all of them, but I definitely do like this one for a drugstore mascara if you guys are looking for one. And for lashes, I'm using these right here. I think they're from Violet Voss, but I'm not 100% sure. Anyway, this is the end of the first eyeshadow look. I hope that you guys like it, and let's move on to the second one. Moving on to the second eyeshadow look, I am again using the P. Louise eyeshadow primer in the shade 2.0. And for this look, I'm starting off with the matte lilac purple, and I'm using the brush that came with the palette, and I'm just applying this all over the lid, the crease, and transition area. Next, I am going into this shimmery purple and applying it to the center of the lid right over the previous color. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but I did apply Fix Plus to the brush because when I was trying to use the color without the Fix Plus, I really just wasn't getting much shimmer. So I did apply Fix Plus. Anyway, now I'm just gonna take a Q-tip again and clean off the edge. Next, I am taking this color and applying it right to the inner corner. Next, I am creating my wing using the Too Faced Better Than Sex eyeliner. Next, with the liner, I did do a cat eye right to the inner corner. I wasn't able to show you guys the process because I have to move my head in all different kinds of directions to be able to do this, so I'm sorry. You don't have to do this step, you can definitely skip it, but yeah. Then I ended up basically adding the Urban Decay glitter right to the bottom lower lash line, just in that little inner corner area. Moving on to the waterline, I am applying this Urban Decay 24/7 pencil in the shade Heartless. Next, I am taking the matte lilac one more time and applying it to the lower lash line. And for mascara, I am taking Fenty Beauty's new mascara. And lastly, I am applying some fake eyelashes. And again, I apologize, I'm not sure the brand of these lashes because I have them all stored in a big lash book from Morphe. So I'm not really sure. I will do better in my next few videos to get new lashes. But anyway, this is the finished look for look number two. So moving on to the last eyeshadow look, again, I am priming my eyes using the P. Louise eyeshadow base. Starting off with the shade Digital, I am going to use the Morphe Jaclyn Hill Very Thin Brush one more time, and I'm starting off this look by basically just mapping out the shape that I want. So now that I've created the shape that I want, I am going to switch over to a bit of a thicker brush, and using the same eyeshadow, I'm just going to color in the inside. Moving on to Purple Dust, I'm just applying this shade right next to the previous color, and I am going to make sure that I apply this right up above my natural crease so that we don't have any transfer, especially for us that have hooded eyes. We don't want anything to transfer once we are finished with the eyeshadow look. Okay, so now I'm moving on to this lighter purple shimmer, and this is where I start to have a hard time, and I decided not to edit any of this out so that you guys can see that, you know, we all struggle. But yeah, I went in with this purple and I did not really like the way that it was looking at all, so then I tried to go in with the minty green. That's my favorite color, but I also did not like the way that that looked, so then I went to this other purple and I did not like that either, because to me it seemed a little bit way too similar to the very first purple that I tried to apply. So I then just decided to go back to the second color that we used and just make everything two colors instead of three, like I had originally planned to do. Also, really quickly, you guys will be able to see that there was still a little bit of the lighter purple peeking through, but it actually turned out kind of nice, so I'm not mad at it. And then here I'm just trying to fix the shape. This actually took me a while to do. I really had to keep going back and forth fixing the shape and just you know, making sure that it was perfect, or at least the way that I thought would look perfect. But anyway, now moving on to the inner corner, and I do end up fixing the shape one more time. I couldn't get the angles because, as you guys can see, I have to move my head really close to the mirror, but I decided to include this little weird part right here so that you guys can see that it's okay to move your head and to get this close to the mirror. Okay, moving on. Next, using the Urban Decay Stay Naked Concealer, I am going to just clean off the edge. Moving on to lining the shape, so I'm taking my Motives Cosmetics little black liner and a very, very thin liner brush. I'm just going to start outlining the shape that we created before, and as you guys can see, I do mess up a little bit at the very outer corner, but it's not a big deal. Yeah, just basically keep going the best that you can, and you don't have to line it with the black if you don't want to. I just thought that it would look better and give it a bit more definition, but you can definitely skip this step if you want to. And then I went back with the Urban Decay Stay Naked Concealer to clean up a little bit more. And now I'm going back to the minty green shade. I totally forgot that I did this, but I actually was not happy with the lighter purple still peeking through. So I went back to the shade, as you guys can see, and I just really took it to like the first third of the lid, and I really liked it. It kind of just mixed in really nicely with the purple and made it a little bit more silver, a little bit more galaxy. So yeah, I really, really liked the way that it turned out. Moving on, I am taking this 24/7 pencil from Urban Decay in black, and I'm lining my waterline and also bringing it down to my lower lash line. Next, I am taking purple dust again, and I'm applying that right over the black liner that we applied on the lower lash line. And lastly, we are applying lashes. And again, I'm so sorry, I don't know who these are from because they're all in that little Morphe lash book. But I suggest you use whatever thick and luscious lashes you have, just because this look just really calls for something like that. I did try to cut some lashes to apply bottom lashes, but I didn't like the way that it looked, so I just left it with a bit of mascara. I believe I used the Fenty Beauty mascara for this one also, but anyway, this is the finished look. I hope that you guys liked all of the looks. If you do decide to recreate any of them, don't forget to tag me on Instagram. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not already, but even if you don't, I just appreciate you being here and watching. And again, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you on the next one. Bye.